Signing an employment contract can be one of the most exciting moments in your career. But there is something very important you must know about restrictive covenants before you pick up the pen. Employees who are too eager to sign contracts that contain restrictive covenants in employment can jeopardize their ability to earn a living in the future. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Sebastien Anderson, founder of Labor Rights Law. We are the go-to virtual law firm providing legal advice to you in the comfort of your own home about employment, labor, and human rights law. This is all that we do. We do it well, and we love what we do. Today, I'm going to talk about restrictive covenants in an employment contract. You'd be surprised what an employer can buy when an employee signs their employment contract. Every day, employees agree to very serious and limiting obligations. Obligations they must keep even after they've left the company in exchange for compensation. There are two types of restrictive covenants commonly found in employment contracts. I'll first be talking about the non-competition clause, then next, we'll be moving on to the non-solicitation clause. The duration of restrictive covenants may exceed the length of time you are entitled to termination pay or pay in lieu of reasonable notice. The first type is a non-competition clause. Employers use non-competition clauses in the contracts of employment to prevent an employee from competing in the same business as the employer within a certain geographical area and a period of time. Generally, the law abhors non-competition clauses because they are a restraint on trade. The non-competition clause must protect the employer's legitimate business interest and have a minimal impact on the employee. If the court finds the non-competition clause to be overly broad or too extreme, the court won't just reduce the length of time and geographical area. Instead, it will strike down the non-competition clause from the employment contract and treat it as if it was never there. That said, even if the non-competition clause is overly broad and likely to be struck down by the court, this does not mean that there are no consequences to signing the employment contract containing it. Consider this scenario. After leaving your position, you're able to find new employment. However, upon receiving a cease and desist letter from your former employer, your new employer decides to terminate its employment relationship with you. Even though your new employer has already been advised that the clause is unlikely to be upheld, you may end up losing a new job again because the contract you signed in a previous job. The second type of restrictive covenant you need to be aware of is a non-solicitation clause. A non-solicitation clause limits an employee's ability to contact their former employer's clients and employees. Compared to non-competition clauses, the courts are more willing to uphold these clauses since they restrain the employee from directly interfering with the legitimate business interests of their former employer. Nevertheless, non-solicitation clauses can still be considered overly broad by the courts, especially if they prevent the employee from contacting the former employer's clients with whom they've had no direct contact, or prevent the employee from soliciting clients or employees for an excessive period of time after the employment relationship ends. Some courts have also clearly indicated that solicitation means asking for something and have therefore allowed employees to accept business from clients of the former employer if the employee is approached by clients of the former employer rather than the employee making direct or indirect contact with their former employer's clients or employees. Before signing an employment contract, it's important to have a lawyer review your contract and provide legal advice to you about the proposed terms and conditions of employment. This is especially important if you are a key employee in senior management or an executive. These restrictive covenants may be more strictly enforced to protect your former employer's legitimate business interests. To know more about your obligations under your employment contract and minimize your risks, visit our page below or contact us at info@laborrightslaw.com.